done stories establishing very clearly how they bribed every single head of state, every important minister, how they delivered the cash in suitcases, and it was dead silence. We are trying to pierce that veil. Don't have one or two voices out there to present factual information to the public, then all hope is lost there, really, quite literally. I think the worst thing that happened to Nigeria was the discovery of oil, because that triggered a series of events that just shattered the social fabric. The oil industry created a system that is so infernal and so corrupt. Nearly everyone has been bought. The headline was, oil minister is in the oil business. The minister was never questioned, to say nothing of being fired. And things just went on as usual. Perhaps the biggest obstacle to progress is the abiding cynicism of the people. They've been disappointed for so long that they no longer believe. It's as if things are supposed to be that way. I had breakfast recently with the chairman of one of the major oil companies. And we just talked about so many things. And then I said, well, look around. You've been here 50 years. You're the largest oil company in Nigeria. What can people see that shows you've ever been here? There is nothing. The ordinary person who is just struggling to get by in life has not a chance if you don't have independent press. The Halliburton story is a simple bribery case. Halliburton wants something and bribes them with cash. And we had the headline, the Halliburton bribe takers, and then went on to detail what happened. What we are trying to do is to make the country confront its own weaknesses. We want to deny them the excuse that they didn't know what was happening. The case of the sick president, we had a headline that says, Yar'Adua is brain damaged, that detailed the fact that he was never coming back in any position to run anything. Within a couple of weeks, the vice president had stepped up. So we hold up the mirror. This is what you are. Here is what's going on. And here is what you can do about it. It's a very basic hope that I have for the country, that it will be a place where a child has a chance, really. But you never know what makes you do things. All of those who have done heroic things throughout history never knew they were going to do that. The way you can think of what we do as being in the business of making enemies. We make new enemies every day. It's more fun collecting enemies than collecting friends.